थैंक यू एंड गुड आफ्टरनून. आज हमारा एजेंडा फॉर दिस प्रेस ब्रीफिंग इज ऑन द ICMR's नेशनल सीरो सर्वे, द फोर्थ सीरो सर्वे दैट हैज़ बीन कंडक्टेड नेशन वाइड. यू आर अवेयर दैट दिस इज़ अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टूल, अ साइंटिफिक टूल अवेलेबल टू असेस द स्प्रेड ऑफ पेंडेमिक एंड टू ड्रॉ लेसन्स टू control and to prognosticate the direction of the pandemic. So this has been a very, very useful exercise. We have done three surveys. Today we are going to hear about the findings of the fourth National Zero Survey. I like to request Professor Balram Bhargav, DG ICMR, Secretary DHR, to kindly make your presentations.
Thank you, sir. Good evening to all. So today we are discussing the fourth round of the National Sero Survey for COVID-19, which was conducted in the last few weeks of June and July, and the beginning of July. We have already concluded three rounds, and we have presented those results, and I'll summarize the results of those three rounds as well. Now, the survey design was different, slightly different from the earlier sero surveys, in the sense that we have included children in this sero survey from 6 to 17 years of age, as well as adults, the general population, which is 28,975 individuals. We also studied the healthcare workers, which were 7,252 individuals. And this was done in the same 70 district as the first survey, second survey, and the third survey in 21 states. 10 villages per ward from each district, 40 individuals per village per ward, and 40 individuals aged more than 6 years per district, 400 individuals more than 6 years per district, and 100 healthcare workers per 100 healthcare workers. Is that better? Okay. Is that better? Yeah. So 100 healthcare workers per district from district and sub-district hospitals. Now, we enrolled 28. Now, let's concentrate on the general population, which includes 6 years and above an adult population. So 6 to 9 years, we had 2,892 individuals. And more than 18 years, we had 20,282. Now, here, interestingly, you have to remember, amongst the adult population, that is more than 18, there was no vaccine in 12,607, that is 62.2%, did not have any vaccination. 24.8% of the people surveyed in the adult population had one dose of the vaccination, and 13% of the individuals had both doses of the vaccine. Now here we have this number, that is the overall seroprevalence is 67.6% in the entire population, which is from 6 years and adults included. Now, if you disaggregate this data of seroprevalence between 6 to 9 years, it was 57.2. 10 to 17 years, it was 61.6%. 18 to 44 years, it was 66.7. Now, 45 to 60, it was higher, 77.6, and more than 60 years, around 77% again. So more than 45 years, it's around 77%, and rest it is about 67% as a major. Male, female, no difference. Rural, urban, there was no difference. It's 66 and 69, slightly higher in the urban areas. Now, this is the trend of seroprevalence over time. That is the first one, which was done in May, June of 2020, where it was 0.7%. Then August, September of 2020 to 7.1%. December, January 2021, it was 24.1%. And today, as we speak, it that is June, July, it is 67.6%. Now the sero survey as per vaccination status. So in unvaccinated, the prevalence was 62.3%. And with one dose of vaccine, it was 81%. And if they had received both the doses, it was 89.8%. Now, that is about the general population and children and adults. Total 67.6%. and highest in the people who were above 45. Now, if you look at the healthcare workers, so we studied 7,252 healthcare workers, and 10% had not taken the vaccine, 90% had taken the vaccine, and the overall seroprevalence in the healthcare workers was 85.2%. So, in conclusion, two-thirds of the general population, that is above the age of 6 years, had SARS-CoV-2 infection. More importantly, a third of the population did not have any antibodies. That is still approximately 40 crore population of this country is still vulnerable. States and districts and areas without antibodies run the risk of infection waves. More than half of the children, 6 to 17 years, were seropositive. And seroprevalence was similar in rural and urban areas. And 85% of the healthcare workers had antibodies against SARS-CoV-2. And 1/10 of the healthcare workers were unvaccinated. That is around 10%. So what are the implications of this serosurvey? So the implications of this large serosurvey done as round number 4 clearly show that there is a ray of hope. But there is no room for complacency. We must maintain COVID-appropriate behavior and community engagement. An important point to remember here is the National Serosurvey is not a substitute for local, that is state or district level survey. It is not a substitute. It is just giving a bird's eye view, the overall picture, panoramic picture of what is happening in the nation. But there is heterogeneity which is occurring from state to state, district to district, and we should be cognizant of that. So state-led sentinel serosurveillance will inform further state-level action. State heterogeneity indicates possibility of future waves of infection. There may be some states which are very low, and the population which is vulnerable is much higher there, and therefore the chances of future waves are higher in those states. Societal, public, religious, and political congregations be avoided. Non-essential travel be discouraged. And travel only if fully vaccinated. So these are some of the messages in terms of the implications. And the way forward is that we need to ensure full vaccination of all healthcare workers as soon as possible. We need to accelerate vaccination coverage in vulnerable population groups. We need to ensure adherence to the non-pharmaceutical interventions. Continue tracking COVID infections in SARI cases in district hospitals. So that is another very important tool, that we use the SARI patients and rule and test them for COVID and rule out if there is any sudden spike of COVID happening in these SARI patients, as we started in March, April last year, when we were doing survey for the beginning of the first wave. We need to identify clusters. If there is a sudden appearance of number of cases in a certain area, we need to look at certain clinical severity, and the INSACOG is tracking the variants of concern. So I will stop here and be happy to answer any question, but more important to remember that there is a ray of hope and there is no room of complacency. We are 2/3 of the way of the population is affected, is positive, seropositive, and 1/3, which is a large population for seeing the size of our country, is still vulnerable and still susceptible. But as the virus needs a susceptible host, so that susceptible host is available in 40 crores in this population. States would vary from state to state, and many states have done their own serosurvey. Some of them are doing it at the district level, and that will be very helpful in further guiding the response to the pandemic. However, the major response of societal, public, religious, and political congregations not happening still remains absolutely important. Non-essential travel to be avoided, and travel only if vaccinated, and community behavior, COVID appropriate behavior and community engagement are absolutely essential for a fight against COVID-19. Thank you so much for your attention.
Thank you, Professor Bhargav. The findings are clear. Findings show us consistency. You may recall that the third serial survey was in December, January. You may take that as the zero prevalence post the end of the first wave. So what you see now as a rise in zero positivity has two factors into it. One is, of course, the second wave, which means the suffering that Delta variant inflicted on us. So that is one part. But also, please note that part of the zero prevalence positivity is also coming from the vaccination coverage. And if you see the slide on unvaccinated vis-a-vis vaccinated, you could see the gradient. Actually, it is the next slide. If you can move to the next slide. This one, you can see the gradient that to the zero positivity, hopefully zero protection, the vaccine is adding to that population level protection, as you can witness from this particular slide. You have noticed that rural-urban gradient is really not much. You have also noticed that the gradient below 18, 10 to 17 gradient is 67% versus 62%. Even 6 to 9 age group children are getting affected. Positivity of 57%. You've seen the data, but I'm just highlighting that particular element. The issue of the fact that 40 crore people, 40 crore 400 million people, by this estimate, have no protective antibodies, no antibodies. We would like them to gain protection through vaccination and not infection. By vaccination and not infection, and that's the endeavor that this nation is mounting. And because such a large pool of vulnerable population is still amongst us, one out of three, wherever you are, out of three of you, one is still vulnerable, and therefore the pandemic is in no way over. Second wave is still persisting. The danger of new outbreaks is very much there. This could be conditioned by the experience of the population for prior experience by way of pandemic and vaccination from state to state, zilla to zilla, population group versus other population group. But the overall vulnerability for the nation still remains, and that's very evident, and the task done and very visible here makes it very clear to us. So we happily, I'm happily endorsing all the messages, Dr. Bhargav, that you have given, and it underlines that our fight with using all the tools at our disposal, tools of COVID-appropriate behavior, very powerfully the vaccination tool, but also tools of testing and tracking and isolating and quarantining cases have to be invoked, have to be continuously pushed in all geographies among all populations of our country. And by way of the situation in the country, you are aware that we still have 41,000 odd new cases. This is overall relatively modest change. If you go back to the start of this month, it's leveling off there. Kerala, still static to slight rise. Maharashtra, some decline, but static. Andhra, still cause for concern. And we have districts with high positivity to the tune of 46 districts. 46 districts have more than 10% positivity, and some of our states are exceeding overall 10% positivity. So the disease is still there, in spite of the, in fact, that testifies to the fact that this level of seropositivity does not ensure that the pandemic is over. It's out there in the states, and 41,000 cases per day is roughly 40% of the size of the first wave. So please take this in a proper context, but we today also compliment the team of ICMR institutions across the country under the leadership of DGICMR, the work that they have done, very high quality, intensive work across the nation in 70 odd zillas, is remarkable. And we would like to congratulate those scientists and team members of technicians, laboratory technicians, field staff, and scientists who mounted this impressive study. I would like in the end to add to the fact that this national level sero survey does not fully allows us to understand the local dynamics, state level or district level, or geography, sub-district level geographies. And for that, we very strongly recommend that there should be timely, high-quality sero surveys in order to understand population, specific population level spread of the disease. So we strongly endorse that. And we are happy that from time to time, there are such surveys. There's one in Maharashtra. There is one published yesterday in public domain from Gujarat. So those surveys are also adding value to this overall understanding of the pandemic. But above all, those are much more useful for local response, because for a country of our size, we do need that level of granularity to, in many aspects, almost all disease matrix or disease indicator aspects, including seropositivity. So congratulations, Dr. Bhakar. Thank you so much for this work, and we are happy to invite questions, particularly on this information that we have shared with public today. Thank you.
Okay, can we start with Avantika?
So, from the slide that you showed, sir, 62% is in unvaccinated. So these are people who have got the seropositivity through infection. What are the dates of the survey? So, at that point of time, what was the total number of cases in the country, and what is the extent of underreporting that we can understand from the survey?
The last 10 days of June and the first week of July, and this has been analyzed quickly. People have worked in the laboratory to look at the data very fast and collated it and done the statistical analysis with full robustness to give us what is the percentages. This is giving you what is happening in the country and giving you an idea. This will not give you a district level or state level prevalence, but it is giving a panoramic view of what is in the nation.
When you interpret these dates, also remember, for seropositivity, it takes about 2 to 3 weeks. So when you're sampling in on, let's say, 30th of June, you actually are looking at the picture of quote-unquote infection
2 weeks
about
before.
two weeks behind, 15th of June, approximately, 15th of June to the end of June. Picture is what you have.
Parimal?
सर, पहले भी जवाब आपसे मिला है पॉल सर आपसे, लेकिन फिर से एक बार सवाल है कि दिल्ली जैसे राज्य जिनको वैक्सीन अगर नहीं मिल रहा है वो शिकायत कर रहे हैं, तो उसके पीछे की वजह क्या है, और कोवैक्सीन का उत्पादन प्रति महीने कितना हो रहा है सर, अगर ये साझा कर पाएं आप सर।
इस सवाल का जवाब हमने पहले भी कोशिश करी है एक्सप्लेन करने की कि वैक्सीन की सप्लाई और वैक्सीन का इम्प्लीमेंटेशन एक बैलेंस्ड एंड इंटररिलेटेड प्रोसेस है। जितना वैक्सीन अवेलेबल हो रहा है उसकी 2 हफ्ते की विजिबिलिटी को लेके स्टेट गवर्नमेंट्स को एंगेज किया जाता है, उनको बताया जाता है, उसके बेस के ऊपर स्टेट गवर्नमेंट्स ने प्लान करना है। और जैसे मैंने एक बार पहले भी कहा था रिसेंटली कि हो सकता है इस तालमेल में कभी थोड़ा बहुत कोऑर्डिनेशन में इशू आ जाता है, क्योंकि CDL से रिलीज होता है, कसौली से बैच रिलीज होता है, उसमें एक दिन पहले हो गया, एक दिन ज़्यादा हो गया, तो थोड़ा बहुत प्लानिंग में फाइन ट्यूनिंग ऑनलाइन होती है, इन रियल टाइम होती है, तो उसी को लेके ही प्लान स्टेट्स को करना चाहिए। और अगर उसी को लेके प्लान करेंगे तो ये शब्द हमें इस्तेमाल करने की ज़रूरत नहीं होगी कि वैक्सीन जो है वो कमी हो गई है, बिकॉज ये पहले ही पता है कि इतना वैक्सीन हमारे पास आने की संभावना है, इसी हिसाब से हमने आगे जाना है। और जैसे जैसे टाइम बढ़ा है, इस कोऑर्डिनेशन में पूरी सशक्तता आई है, इस कोऑर्डिनेशन इज मच मोर सीमलेस, अ लॉट ऑफ इट इज इलेक्ट्रॉनिक, लॉट ऑफ इट इज डिस्कशन ऑन अ वेरी पीरियोडिक बेसिस, तो उसी परिप्रेक्ष्य में लेना चाहिए। जैसे मैंने बताया था आपको, कोवैक्सीन में जो उन्होंने एक्सपेंशन प्लान बनाया था, उसमें उन्होंने अंकलेश्वर और बेंगलोर में फैसिलिटीज़ को ऐड किया, हैदराबाद की फैसिलिटी के अलावा। और उसमें अंकलेश्वर वाला जो प्लांट है उनका ठीक तरह से प्रोडक्शन की तरह बढ़ा है एज़ पर शेड्यूल, लेकिन बेंगलोर की फैसिलिटी में उनको कुछ इनिशियल वैलिडेशन की, जो इनिशियल स्टेबलाइजेशन होता है, ऑपरेशनलाइजेशन होता है, उसमें कुछ डिफ़िकल्टीज आई हैं, जिसकी वजह से थोड़ा सा उनके प्लान के हिसाब से जितना देश उम्मीद कर रहा था उससे थोड़ा पीछे, इट्स ओनली अ मैटर ऑफ टाइम, लेकिन जितना मुझे विदित है कि वो सारे इश्यूज अब सॉर्ट आउट हो गए हैं, और इस स्टेज पे जितनी प्रोडक्शन उन्होंने प्लान करी थी उस प्लांट से, उसी प्रकार से उनकी प्रोडक्शन आगे बढ़ रही है। सो दिस हिच हैज़ बीन सॉर्टेड आउट, लेकिन एक फेज़ में थोड़ा सा वो पीछे, थोड़ा उनकी तरफ से इस वजह से अनफोर्सीन सर्कमस्टांस है, ये ऐसे टेक्निकल काम है, नई जगह पे एक प्लांट बन रहा है, इसके बहुत हाई स्टैंडर्ड्स होते हैं, ये लाइव वायरस को टैकल किया जाता है, तो इस्टेब्लिश करते करते थोड़ा सा उनको वक्त थोड़ा एक्स्ट्रा लगा है, बट नाउ दे आर ऑन ट्रैक।
सर, देयर इज एन ऑनलाइन क्वेश्चन एंड मेनी ऑफ आवर मीडिया फ्रेंड्स सिटिंग हियर लाइक नितेंद्र, प्रफुल्ल, दे ऑल वांटेड टू नो that now that the cases of COVID have reduced in many districts, this question is from Sneha Mordani, India Today, who sent us online, that now that the cases of COVID have reduced in many districts, many of which have positivity rate of less than 5%, is the government going to plan opening of schools and colleges in a staggered way, like being suggested by many experts?
I think that's a very important question. Regarding schools and children, we know clearly that children can handle viral infections much better than adults. Young children, it has been established, have lower number of receptors, that is the ACE receptors is much lower in children where the virus attaches. And antibody exposure we have seen in our presentation, in very young children, it is very similar to adults. So 57.2 versus 66.7 or 61.2. So the antibody exposure is also similar in children. Having said that, there have been some countries, particularly the Scandinavian countries, many parts of Europe, wherein they did not shut down their primary schools during the first wave, second wave, third wave, whatever waves they had, their primary schools were always open. So once India starts considering and the districts start considering, it will be wise to open primary schools first. And that should be done before the schools for secondary schools. And also, we have to ensure that all the support staff, whether it be the school bus drivers or the teachers or the staff in the schools, they need to be vaccinated. Thank you. तो जैसे आपको बताया कि छोटे बच्चे वायरस को बहुत आसानी से हैंडल कर लेते हैं, अडल्ट से ज़्यादा आसानी से हैंडल कर देते हैं, और छोटे बच्चों में कुछ एस रिसेप्टर्स कम होते हैं उनकी लंग्स में, जहाँ पे वायरस अटैच करता है तो उनके लंग में एस रिसेप्टर्स कम होते हैं, तो इसलिए उनमें इन्फेक्शन कम होता है, देखा गया है। मगर दूसरी बात ये भी देखी गई है इस सर्वे में, आप देखिए कि 6 से 9 वर्ष के बच्चों में 57.2% एंटीबॉडीज है, जो बिल्कुल एडल्ट के बराबर ही है, उनका 62-64 के करीब है, तो बिल्कुल बराबर ही है। और जैसे कि कई यूरोप के देशों में उन्होंने प्राइमरी स्कूल बंद ही नहीं किए थे, चाहे फर्स्ट वेव हो, चाहे सेकंड वेव हो, चाहे थर्ड वेव हो, उनके यहाँ स्कूल खुले रहे थे प्राइमरी स्कूल। और ये इसलिए मैं हम लोग की हिदायत ये है कि प्राइमरी स्कूल खोले जा सकते हैं पहले खोले जा सकते हैं, क्योंकि क्योंकि बच्चों में जैसे मैंने रीजंस आपको बताए, तो प्राइमरी स्कूल्स में पहले खोले जाने चाहिए और फिर सेकेंडरी स्कूल खोले जा सकते हैं। मगर ये देखना ज़रूरी है कि जितना भी सपोर्ट स्टाफ है, चाहे स्कूल के बस ड्राइवर्स हों या टीचर्स हों या प्राइमरी स्कूल में और सपोर्ट स्टाफ है, वो सब वैक्सीनेटेड होना ज़रूरी है।
वन लास्ट क्वेश्चन प्लीज मिलन।
सर, क्या ये बता सकते हैं कि कौन सी डिस्ट्रिक्ट्स इनमें से जो आपने सीरो सर्वे किया है उसमें हाईएस्ट सीरो प्रेवलेंस देखा गया, कौन सी डिस्ट्रिक्ट्स थी जहां पर सीरो प्रेवलेंस अभी भी बहुत लो है?
ये तो बहुत क्लियर है, आपका जो टेस्ट पॉजिटिविटी रेट है, हम लोग डिस्ट्रिक्ट वाइज फॉर द लास्ट 3 मंथ्स हम लोग डिस्ट्रिक्ट वाइज टेस्ट पॉजिटिविटी रेट वीकली एवरेज क्लियरली देते हैं, और वो तो पॉजिटिविटी वेल एस्टेब्लिश्ड है। मगर इस नेशनल सीरो सर्वे में डिस्ट्रिक्ट लेवल पे एनालिसिस करना विल नॉट बी करेक्ट, स्टैटिस्टिकली इट विल नॉट बी करेक्ट, एंड इट इज़ नॉट वाइज टू एक्सट्रपोलेट डेटा विच इज़ अ नेशनल डेटा टू द डिस्ट्रिक्ट लेवल। एज डॉक्टर पॉल क्लियरली सेड, देर इज हेट्रोजेनाइटी बिटवीन डिस्ट्रिक्ट, देर इज हेट्रोजेनाइटी बिटवीन स्टेट्स, एंड दैट इज़ वाई वी अर्ज दोज डिस्ट्रिक्ट एंड स्टेट्स टू कैरी आउट देयर ओन सीरो सर्वे, बट this is giving us a national picture or a national flavor of where we stand today. Yes, it is a decision which will have to be taken by the at the district level and the state level, depending on several factors, depending on factors as I have already explained, in terms of what is the vaccination of the teachers, what is the vaccination of the support staff, what is the test positivity rate in that district, and what is public health situation of that district. Accordingly, it can be decided. जैसे कि आपको बताया है और आपको मालूम है कि हम लोग का जो मॉडलिंग डेटा ऑलरेडी पब्लिश्ड है, 25 जून को आपने देखेंगे कि 25 जून को हम लोग ने मॉडलिंग डेटा पब्लिश किया था इंडियन जर्नल ऑफ मेडिकल रिसर्च। आई वुड अर्ज यू टू रीड दैट। उसमें 4 या 5 रीजंस क्लियरली दिए गए थे, जिसमें था कि डिक्रीज्ड इम्यूनिटी हो जाए, जो इम्यूनिटी आपको किसी चीज़ से मिली, चाहे वैक्सीन से मिली, चाहे आपको इन्फेक्शन से मिली, वो कब देखा गया है कि दैट इज़ एटलीस्ट वैलिड फॉर अप टू अ ईयर, दैट इज़ नोन। सेकेंड पॉइंट इज इम्यून एस्केप हो सकता है कि नहीं। तीसरा पॉइंट है कि कोई ज़्यादा ट्रांसमिसिबल वेरिएंट आ गया। पांचवी चीज़ ये देखी गई है कि आपने प्रीमेच्योरली रिस्ट्रिक्शन ईज कर दिए, तो वहाँ पे रिबाउंड हो सकता है थोड़ा सा। और ये उसमें क्लियरली ये देखा गया है कि अगर आप लोग कोविड अप्रोप्रिएट बिहेवियर करेंगे, यदि वेरिएंट ऑफ कंसर्न नहीं एमर्ज होता है और हम लोग की वैक्सीनेशन का दर चलता रहता है तेजी से, तो फिर हम लोग को कोशिश करनी है कि तीसरी वेव नहीं आए।
एंड एज आई मेंशन, फ्यूचर वेव के लिए तैयार रहें, ये एक फैसला है, एक डिसीशन है और एक संकल्प है। और दूसरा संकल्प साथ साथ ये है कि इतना सब कुछ, ये चीज़ें जो बार बार कही जा रही हैं, वो हम कलेक्टिवली करें। कोविड अप्रोप्रिएट बिहेवियर, राइजिंग वैक्सीनेशन कवरेज, ट्रेसिंग, ट्रैकिंग, टेस्टिंग, ये सब अच्छी तरह से, कंटेनमेंट जोन, ये सब हम करेंगे तो ये भी बहुत बहुत संभव है कि थर्ड वेव जैसी कोई चीज़ नहीं आएगी। तो दोनों ही ट्रैक पे हमें मेहनत करनी है और संकल्प लेना है.
वन पॉइंट आई जस्ट ऐड इन हियर, इट इज फ्रॉम योर, इट विल बी योर एफर्ट बिकॉज इट इज मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट फॉर द सोसाइटी टू हेल्प अस आउट. एंड इफ योर एफर्ट्स आर ब्रिलियंट देन सोसाइटल पब्लिक religious and political congregations, if they are avoided, we should not and we can avoid a third wave. And if COVID appropriate behavior, as sir is saying, as well as engagement of the community, if that happens, and as the vaccination process is moving in on its pace, that continues, we should try our best to avoid a third wave.
और आपने बड़ी अच्छी तरह से लिखा कि non-essential travel को avoid करिए, जहाँ भी तक संभव हो सके वैक्सीनेशन करवाने के बाद ही ट्रैवल करिए, भीड़ में मत जाइए, भीड़ मत पैदा करिए, ये बहुत आगे तक जाएगा. और साथ में हमें ये भी उम्मीद करनी चाहिए कि वायरस का जो एक्स फैक्टर है, कि वायरस अपना बहुरूपिया रूप ही अगर अलग बदल लेता है तो सारी इक्वेशन बदल जाती है, उस फैक्टर को भी याद रखना चाहिए. देयरफॉर देयर कैनॉट बी लोअरिंग ऑफ द गार्ड, वी शुड बी प्रिपेयर्ड, वी शुड बी एम्पली प्रिपेयर्ड, वी शुड बी ऑल यूनाइटेड. एट द सेम टाइम अगर ये हम करेंगे तो ज़रूरी नहीं है कि कोई भी आउटब्रेक आए, हम इसको काबू में रख सकते हैं और दबा के रख सकते हैं जब तक हमारा वैक्सीनेशन कवरेज बहुत अच्छा हो जाएगा, और साथ साथ हम अपनी ज़िंदगी भी चला सकते हैं और कोरोना को भी एक लिमिटेड नंबर में ही पुश करके अपने आप को आगे बढ़ा सकते हैं. धन्यवाद.